There she is.
Gwei from Sable Island. My name's Lundley. I'm from Annapolis Valley First Nation. I'm a earthkeeper. I'm here on Sable Island looking for sweat bee nests. And it's not as easy as what you'd think it would be. Get it? Bee? Ha ha ha. Anyways.
Hi, I'm Dan Keeler, the park ecologist for Sable Island National Park Reserve.
Gwei, Delo C. Cheyenne McDonald, Mi'kmaq First Nation. I'm here representing the Confederacy of Mainland Mi'kmaq, and we're here to study the Sable Island sweat bee.
The story of this Sable Island sweat bee is pretty cool because it was only discovered about 10 years ago thanks to a researcher who was looking at all these collected bees in museums, including bees that were collected here in Sable Island in the 70s. Through their detailed analysis and also looking at some DNA barcoding, they were able to differentiate the bees from Sable Island into a separate species. And now we consider it an endemic species to Sable Island. That means it's found only here. And because of that, it's also a species at risk.
So here we are. We found some more bees. The wind will cooperate with us. So what we're doing is we're trying to find out where they are, where they nest, and then we're going to further study them.
So I just saw a bee go in this area under the plantain. When they come out, they'll do an orientation flight, buzz around, that way they get all the landmarks, and then go forage and come back, so that we can keep track of them. I'm gonna put this washer right on top of where I think she went in, and it's labeled. So we'll be able to track how many nests we find in this area. Very cool.
I've came to the conclusion that we should call them stubborn bees because they're really hard to find.
We are at the one living tree on Sable Island, the last tree from a tree planting effort. And just around this tree, we've struck gold. We've got four nests so far. Looks like we're gonna find quite a few more here. And it's a super nice day for bees. We just brought one of the bees we caught back into the lab. We need the stereoscope to see the pattern on the top of the thorax really well. That's the only way that we can identify them in the field, so to speak.
I just wanted to give my indigenous perspective, being Ilnu Mi'kmaq, of my reflection on my time here on Sable Island. I didn't know what to expect when I first came out. I heard people try to explain their experiences to me and I didn't quite understand. They told me that I wouldn't get it until I was here. And now I get it. Sable Island seems to have an energy that is more natural than the mainland or anywhere else I've been. It has a slow, steady, consistent rhythm, the way that Sable Island has affected me spiritually. I think I found myself here. I discovered who I was, or who I am. Something I think that every Ilnu person should experience. I'm really hoping that I'll be able to come back again. Hello, hello.
Bye!
We'll miss you!